Well, it's no secret the newspapers around the world have been struggling in this internet age, with many of them folding up during the recession. KCRA3's Walt Gray joins us right now with a story of how one Sacramento paper is holding its own, Walt.
Gulston, people who live in the downtown Sacramento area can't help but see Sacramento News and Review stacks piled high, and it's free. It's a paper known for in-depth investigations where somebody seemingly is getting wronged by a corporate bully. Now, we'll get to the interesting ads in a moment. The Sacramento News and Review has been cranking it out for 20 years, surviving as a free newspaper, and because of that, getting through the recession better than others.
We took a dip last year, but it's really picking up, and as things with the dailies get worse, it's been getting better for us.
The News and Review prints weekly, and Von Kanel says that's the way it'll stay no matter what happens to other newspapers in town.
We do a fair amount of investigative stories, but we also do a lot of cultural stories and kind of fun stories. We take the perspective of what's really interesting here in Sacramento, and then put a little bit of flair to that.
Howdy. Hey, how you guys doing?
Good.
The next issue rolls out tomorrow. The cover, the bounty hunter, Leonard Padilla. The paper calls him a reality show in his own mind. And yes, those ads. Many ads you wouldn't want your grandma to see unless she's pretty hip. A wide range of escort services, massage, music, personals, and some regular ads you'd see in any other newspaper.
We have controversial ads, and just like we have controversial stories, our ads are much more affordable, and they allow a lot of the smaller places who couldn't afford other media as a place to reach their audience and for our audience to be able to find them.
The News and Review is also moving December 1st from their rental on 20th Street to Del Paso Boulevard, where they're buying and renovating a building with 7,000 more square feet.
Part of the upheaval and the refurbishing of Del Paso Boulevard as well. And the News and Review's weekly circulation, 77,000, which is not even close to the Sacramento Bee's daily 268,000 readers.
Well, so we've seen over the past year, since the economy's gone down, we've seen the Sac Bee lay off some of its workers. How many people working over here?
They have 60 full-time people, Gulston, and they have a slew of freelancers as well. You come up with a good story idea, they'll pay you for it. So everything seems to be going well there as long as the ad dollars keep rolling in, and apparently they've weathered the economic storm. So maybe it's gravy from here.
Yeah, and also, I mean, really isn't the attraction that it just is able to kind of capture a little bit more of the alternate personality of Sacramento? I mean, that's really what it's all about.
Absolutely. Their target audience is the Whole Foods market in Java City. So it's not Starbucks.
Nope.
It's Whole Foods.
And the audience is out there. Okay, Walt, thanks for that.
Sure.